I would never do that. When was the last time you said or thought that? For me, it was actually last night. Why? Because I am shocked by the actions of others. I am shocked by the news of the day. I'm shocked by the evil that abounds and lawlessness, injustices, and prejudices all around. And I stop and think, how can someone do that? I would never. How can someone, any human being with a heart, do that thing? Me? I would never. Think about it. Maybe not even the obvious narratives that surround us culturally at the moment. Let's bring it closer to home a bit. What about family, friends, or people you call friends, yet behind their backs, or as you read their posts on social media, have you judged actions or lack of actions and proclaimed to someone very self-righteously, I would never do what she did or what he did? I have. Guilty. It's so easy to say because some of the things we are seeing are horrific, and I find myself wanting to separate myself in some way. Other times when I've said it or thought it, I guess I wanted to put myself in some sort of self-righteous category as I watch life play out for others and think, I would never make that choice, or I would never put myself in that situation. As I've found myself saying, I would never, the Spirit gently reminded me how Jesus turned everything upside down in Matthew chapter 5 and basically tells me, oh, but you have. He explains the true condition of my heart. We are told not to murder, but Jesus said, if you're angry at a brother, you're guilty. We are told not to commit adultery, but Jesus said, if you've even looked and lusted in your heart, you're guilty. Then he steps on toes big time, telling us to love our enemies, bless those who curse us, and do good to those who hate us, and pray for those who spitefully use us and persecute us. As quickly as I've found myself saying, I would never, I just as quickly paused and acknowledged, there but for the grace of God go I. That phrase is attributed to a man named John Bradford, who was burned at the stake for his faith in the 1500s. He would often say it as he watched prisoners being taken to the place of execution. He would say, but for the grace of God, there goes John Bradford. John Bradford was very aware of his heart condition and the flesh that can so easily lead us down paths of darkness. Paul was also aware of God's grace in his life. 1 Corinthians 15:9. For I am the least of the apostles and do not even deserve to be called an apostle because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace to me was not without effect. No, I worked harder than all of them, yet not I, but the grace of God that was with me. It is thought that this scripture was the inspiration for John Bradford's often used phrase, there but for the grace of God go I. May it challenge us today when we are quick to say, I would never, may we be even quicker to look deep into our own heart and recognize and be shocked by our own anger, our own lust, our own sin and say, oh, but I have, and oh, I am capable. We are all guilty like John Bradford and Paul both. May we see and understand what it means to walk in humility, knowing we are no better than those we point our fingers at. I am what I am only by the grace of God. That's the truth. May I never forget it. I'm Lori Klein.